the future, capital F, be it crystalline city on the hill or radioactive post-nuclear wasteland, is gone. Up ahead of us, now, there's merely more stuff. Events. Some tending to the crystalline, some to the wastelandy. Stuff. The mixed bag of the ongoing quotidian. Every future is someone else's past. Every present, someone else's future. Upon arriving in the capitalized future, we discover it invariably to be the lowercase now.
We'll be right back. very little about how well one's life has been led. That no matter how much you've done or how successful you've been, there's always more to do, always more to learn, and always more to achieve. And I want to say to you today, you too cannot rest on your laurels. You can't rest. Your own body of work is also yet to come. We gather here tonight in times of extraordinary difficulty for the world. Now, in the face of these challenges, it may be tempting to fall back on the formulas for success that have been peddled so frequently in recent years. Now, you can take that road, but such an approach won't get you where you want to go. It displays a poverty of ambition. That in fact, the elevation of appearance over substance, of celebrity over character, of short-term gains over lasting achievement, is precisely what your generation needs to help in. First of all, it distracts you from what's truly important. It may lead you to compromise your values and your principles and your commitments. The leaders we revere, they are not generally the result of a narrow pursuit of popularity or personal advancement.
spark has burned out. We've become satisfied, well fed, and unafraid. Where once we hungered, baying like wolves, scenting. Senseless mongrels, dreaming of a hunger long forgotten, but clouded with modern ideals, restraint and morality. I know the fire still burns. I felt its heat and tasted that unquenchable thirst.
Yeah.
The people.